Hello, hunters. I'm the SurvivalVis, and we return to the Hunter Classic after quite a long time away covering the Way of the Hunter series. Apparently, in an interesting stroke of just like happenstance, Way of the Hunter lasted 54 episodes, which is the same length I did the Hunter Classic's initial series run for up until I started the Expedition little mini-series of it. So that was an interesting little quirk to learn from the comments last week, and just with everything wrapping up and bringing Way of the Hunter to a close for a couple of weekends. I still am going to tackle Way of the Hunter Aurora Shores, but there was a new animal added to the Hunter Classic, and I do think we could use a little bit of a breath of fresh air or just a little breather before we go back to Way of the Hunter. So we're back in the Hunter Classic to try going after the Wood Grouse. Well, them and anything else I can come across. Okay, F is whistle. We'll have to remember not to press that button. But our loadout is going to be pretty simple today. We're going to take 300 out. We're going to take the 12 gauge with birdshot. And then we're also going to pack along the 243 just in case we do come across any small game animals. I'm not going to exclusively go after only the wood grouse, but we're going to try to use the callers that have come out for it. As I guess with the Halloween event, I had a bit of EM saved up from something. I can't exactly remember what, but we're going to see about using the locator caller and the box caller, and see try to get a few wood grouse more easily with them. And the wood grouse, I mean, they've been released for a few months now. I know there's a lot of people hoping I would go back and check them out. I kind of figured because they weren't a limited time event, I wouldn't put a big urgency on them. Just because, like, the Halloween stuff, you only had for 2-3 weeks of the year. That's it. The wood grouse are a permanent addition, so it doesn't really matter too much when I'd go back and see them. So that's why I figured I'd try to kill off the Way of the Hunter story stuff, get that completely done, over with. We can say that's, like, finalized, complete, and now we can easily enjoy a nice break with the Hunter Classic. And the maps that the wood grouse are on, I think it's 3 total. I think it's Hirschfelden, Hemmeldal, and Val des Bois. I'm not 100% sure on the last one, but I think it's 3 different maps they are present on. And hopefully they're going to be common enough that we don't have to go too long before we'll find any. I'm not exactly sure how they're going to be, like, just out in the world. I don't know if because they are wood grouse, they'll stick to, like, forest patches, or we might find them out in the middle of the fields. We'll basically just get some distance, then try the locator call and see if we get any responses in. Yeah, that's the little locator we got right now. I think once we hit the little crossroad there, we'll give that a shot and see if anything is in the area to reply back. I also, maybe what I'll try doing, oh right, M is for the map, that makes sense. Maybe I'll try going down this way first, because I've never really ventured down this area too much. So we'll change things up, get a little bit of fun back with Hunter Classic, and just see how my skills have transferred over or how poorly they've translated. It is one of the things with how Way of the Hunter was as a series, I kind of feel like it might be easier doing the Hunter Classic. I mean, I've definitely got more experience with the Hunter Classic than Way of the Hunter, but it has also been, well, I don't even know how long since I last touched the Hunter Classic. It had to have been the Halloween event stuff from October. Was it October or November? I can't remember how it was done, because was it like a week before Halloween and a week after? Maybe it was something like that for the timing of it, but I know the Halloween event lasted quite a bit longer than I thought it would. Well, I just take, not that, I want, that's right, B for binoculars. Okay, I think, those are just rocks down there. I thought maybe that was actually, like, boars or something. Yeah, I don't see anything out and about here. So let me just try the locator and see. And then, yeah, we're going to try going down this way. Let's see. When I went to select the 2 lodges for Hirschfelden, they both said wood grouse are around them, so I'm hoping they're going to be like a bit of a common occurrence to find. You just always got to give it a little bit of time and slowly hike and see what we come across. And another nice thing about coming back to Hunter Classic is we have a lot of stuff we can compare back and forth between the 2 games. Like, I do feel the Hunter Classic... There are some things I'm expecting to eventually see in Way of the Hunter. Things like going to choose, like, your own clothing options and gear or equipment that way. I also do see... I feel like they still do have to do something about, like, the 3 binocular slots for Way of the Hunter. It just feels weird to me that you have 3. I could see 2. One for binocular, one for rangefinder. But the third one just catches me off guard, because, like, why would you need a third optic? You already got the other 2. So I don't know if maybe they'll shift something around, maybe say, like, they'll change that to a call slot. Not roe deer tracks. I don't... No. Roe deer call. Oh, see, that'd be interesting to go for. I wonder if I should just try going for it. I mean, this... It's not exactly an exclusive Wood Grouse episode. You know what? Maybe we'll try working our way towards it. I did not pack any other callers, I don't think. But I can probably switch this out for the 243 that... And yeah, that scope will work. Actually, now I think about it, I better make sure my weapons are loaded first, because that might be a problem if I try going after the Wood Grouse. Yeah, let's get that loaded up. There we go. Oh. Okay, so we do have some wild boar. Again, I don't think I really want to go after any of those guys. Okay, yeah, so it's this next field over. I feel like there should be enough I keep Way the Hunter reflex right there. I keep the binoculars bound on the 4th key, so I always be selecting that when I'm just trying to get the regular binoculars. Okay, I'm hoping if I stay low, I can sneak by these ones. I don't think they'll cause me any problems, but I also never know for sure. You're kind of waddling at a quicker rate, though. Okay, good news is that roe deer, it is a little bit more off. So yeah, we should be able to actually get a good line of sight to it using the hill we're coming up to. Although, you just kind of slow down there, bud. I can't tell if it's a pair of males or one's a female or not, but... Okay, there we go. Spotting starting to come into effect. Yeah, we'll just hopefully be passing you by and you're not going to care at all. Although your bud back there... No, you guys don't really care. You don't look like you're really impressive males either. I mean, the tusks do come up a little bit from the snout, but... I don't think anything too spectacular for them. Yeah, so we should be good, be able to sneak up over here... and see what this roe deer looks like. I do have to be careful with shooting, though, because one thing's about coming back to the Hunter Classic is there's going to be the weapon skills come back into effect, which means there's probably going to be a fair bit of weapon sway, unless I am fully prone. I know you're probably just going towards the road because it's easier to travel along, but still makes me a little anxious. Yeah, we're getting to a decent spot to be able to look out and see from here. It does kind of look like that roe deer might be right up along the hill before us. Oh, no, that might be him right there. And again, I keep pulling out the wrong item. Yeah, it's not very impressive, but you know what? I think I'd rather go for him than one of the boars. So let's see how my shot placement is, although... We'll wait for him to stop moving first. I'm trying to remember... There we go, and it is space here. Actually, now that I think about it, I can't remember Is the steady breath the way the hunter shift, or is it space as well? I cannot remember off the top of my head now that I'm not actually playing it. Yeah, we'll go snag you. And then we'll keep trying with the locator call. I'm guessing we probably won't hear anything because of the gunshot will have spooked any animals in the area out. But maybe we'll keep working down this way and just see. But overall, though, I don't feel like there's too much I'm, like, making mistakes of, or too hard set one mindset or the other, like, going back and forth from the two games. I feel like the Hunter Classic might be a little lighter on certain mechanics, although, truth be told, one thing I do love is the free look as you're moving around. I'm kind of surprised that never made it into Call of the Wild as well, because it's such a handy little thing just to, like, say you want to keep yourself... Ooh. Oh wait, those are pheasants, aren't they? You know what? You could always go and see about trying to get a pheasant. So let's just snag you. Yeah, right through both lungs. Why one GM? Not too much. Should we take a trophy? Yeah, it's our first one back. You know what? Let's take a trophy shot. I figure just because it is our first time back and first animal we've hunted for the Hunter Classic for months, we might as well just do a little something to commemorate it. Slide you there. Take that. And we're good. Okay. So yeah, we'll get the shotgun at the ready, get a little bit of practice, I guess, with the bird shot and see how I do after all this time. And once again, I continually mess that up. It's going to happen all for these next couple weekends, I'm sure, just because I've gotten so used to the habit of pulling out binoculars in the way of the hunter, but maybe I'll be able to break it with a little more time. Okay, I guess it's just my own footsteps I'm hearing. No, flock of can of geese. Oh, hang on, is that the pheasant there? There's just a little bit of... Well, I guess not. Okay, so we got, like, both ends. There was a call from over here. I can't really see... Yeah, I don't really see where it is or was making the calls before. You know what? I'll try the caller again. Yeah, see, I'm not hearing anything back for the wood grouse, so I do wonder if there is specific areas I've got to try working at more. Okay, but that pheasant call came from right around here. Could have easily wandered off to somewhere else. Ooh. Actually, that might be it right there I'm looking for. Yeah, okay, just kept going over through the area here. I'll just get the shotgun at the ready again, and be careful as we go up. Yeah, one thing about the Hunter Classic that I still really enjoy is... Oh, there you are. It's just the fact that you can have this more like a free roam hunting experience. You can take a few weapons out, have a variety of animals and game you can go after. I want to get him more when he's in the air, just because... There we go. Managed to get him. I wonder if a little bit of practice from Way of the Hunter and leading the shots more has paid off. No, I do see... Oh, come on, get the binoculars out. Are those pheasants? Oh no, those are geese. Okay, I probably scared them off with the shotgun. We'll let them all go, though. And go snag the bird. I was going to say, because of the way the hunter having to practice all the shot lead for, like, the waterfowl, maybe I've kept a little bit of that knowledge coming into here. Let's see how you do. 25 GM I don't think's too bad for a little pheasant. We won't trophy shot it, though. Save that for our first wood grouse or some bigger game. And let me work down this way. Just again, going to areas I haven't really gone through in any of my coverage for the Hunter Classic. Because I still kind of feel like the wood grouse would make most sense to find them in, like, wooded areas. Nope. Actually, I should bring my binoculars back out, because there is somebody way across there. I think... Okay, that might be a female roe deer. Can't tell for sure. There are more pheasants, but again, I'm not super after them. Just a few birds. Yeah, I think that's just a female roe deer standing out there. I'll keep going my way south a bit, keep trying the locator call, and see if we can get any responses. Because I think the wood grouse will actually be one of the easier animals to get with the equipment I picked up. I don't know if they would need to be... I kind of imagine they might be sort of like turkey for hunting, where you have the different callers to try to bring them in. You could set up dummies, but I don't know if you'll super have to. Because I know just trying to browse the shop and, like, think, okay, what gear will help me show these guys off the best? The two callers seem like the big things to get. No, actually, hang on. I should bring my binoculars out, because there's... more things over that way. What are they? Wow. Okay, that red deer actually looks really good. I was not planning to see... Nope, let me just check that. Although, I think it was a pheasant, wasn't it? Yeah. Okay, you know what? Let me get this swapped out and ready, because if I can, I'm going to take that red deer out there. That's a decent-looking one. Not you, not you. Okay, I think it went behind the hill there, perhaps. Actually, one of the things that might be interesting is, without using the callers to bring stuff in, I might be able to be a little bit more undetected as I spot the animals. Because I think that was one of my problems with the Hunter Classic for myself, is I try to call them in, but then that also brings their sight more towards, like, what I'm up to. So I'd kind of shoot myself a bit in the foot. And yeah, he is right behind that big hill there. And, okay, there's quite a few pheasants over in that field. Not really what I'm after. I've got to figure out how I'm going to handle this. Oh, maybe actually he will do the work for me. So yeah, you guys can probably see him just a bit in the move. There we are. Yeah, he's easy to see when you're not zoomed in because of the render distance on the plants. The problem is just... See, I've got a lot of sway right now, and it's hard to see him. I'd love for you to just keep coming up that hill. No, I can't take the shot. I don't know. I didn't think I'd be this unsteady with the weapon. Oh, no. Binoculars again. Although it looks like waiting him out actually might pay off for a lot. He still wants to stay in the trees, though. It's gonna make getting a really good shot at him difficult. And again, one thing I do not miss is how bad the weapon sway is for, like, trying to hunt in Wave the Hunter. Like, on the one hand, it's kind of nice to have a progression system, but on the other, it's also really, really annoying at certain times. Oh. Well, there's a little pheasant right there. Okay, he's not in the greatest of spots, but... what's he doing? Oh, he's actually coming back. That might be what I need. But he's still just it's like a tease of a shooting gallery. You know that's a big scorer, but it just does not want to give you your opening. That's it. Come on back. Come on up the hill. No, don't... Ooh. There we go. I was going to say, I wasn't sure what was happening to him there, but I guess the... Oh, hang on. Oh, again, I think that's a fallow deer over there. I just saw, like, the little splash of color. Whatever it is, it ran off, but... Yeah, I guess he got stuck between, like, the terrain and some of the trees in that, which kind of propped him up into perfect shooting range. Sometimes you just gotta take what the game glitches out and gives you. So we'll go see how it scores for points, and keep trying for getting, like, any reply from the Wood Grouse. I probably should have done a little bit more research onto, like, where we'll find it, but that is one of the things, too, as I'm, like, between episodes getting the recording sorted out, I can even do a quick check and see if I'm, like, on the right track or not. Yeah, let's come over here, snag this red deer, and take a look at how he scores. Because again, this one, I doubt it's like really big trophy, but it still looked pretty decent from the distance out. So it should be somewhere around here. Oh yeah, there you are. More pheasant calls. And we do have a bit more time before I will end this first episode, but let's pick him up and see how he ranks. Da-da-da-da! 207 isn't too bad, especially not the 62 GM from him. So yeah, let's just zoom back a little bit. You're definitely an animal worth the trophy shot. I think that's good there. And actually, I think I might have heard the Wood Grouse for a second there. Let me try bringing out their caller and giving it a try. I just heard, like, a really heavy flapping of wings, and I thought, I've never heard it before. Yeah, I'm hearing some weird sounds, but nothing... Well, I mean, I'm getting pheasants to call out, but not the Wood Grouse. Maybe I'll follow the road for a little bit longer, and then between recordings, I'll just do a quick check and see, like, the best locations to try coming across them. Because I'd hate to have it, we try to focus on getting a Wood Grouse for the first weekend we're back for the Hunter Classic, and we completely don't even see or hear from them. You see all kinds of pheasant calls in that. There's a female there. Another female up there. I mean, aside from the can of goose I keep hearing flocking over, Nothing else. And we do got a pheasant right there. We'll see if we can get this guy up here, and then that'll probably be the last animal to go for this episode. I still do want to try to keep the time frame around half hour per video. I know I used to do the Hunter Classic a little bit longer, but just with how the schedule is, I can't quite have everything going as long as I used to. Still gotta time it all out if I can. And where are these? Oh, no, not pheasant tracks. Red deer. Okay, it's possible those were what I had come across, or that was the herd with the 207 scoring one. Again, not trophy, but still a decent size. Not too bad for our first return to the for the weekend, but I swear I can talk. This just feels like tradition for the Hunter Classic in a way, I think. Okay, and the pheasant was just up here. I think now that all the grass has kind of spawned in. It's possible he might have gone up there. And I got spooked with me trying to approach. Yeah, I don't think I want to go for him up in the trees, though. I suppose I could always just try and pop them. We'll go up and see. Yeah, supposedly... somewhere maybe just ahead of us. Once it gets into the underbrush, though, you have a... oh! Okay, he was up there, but I think he got pressured a little bit and is still, like, roaming away from me. Okay, there was something that just popped up for a minute, like I was able to spot, but... I couldn't make out what the info for it was about. Oh, apparently there's a... I spotted a fallow deer. I didn't even realize there was one right around here. Yeah, see that pheasant? No idea where it's... oh! I mean, it is such a tiny little sucker, but I guess I could try taking it. That should be a lung shot. Yeah, there we go. Just this little stick fallow. I guess I can say we got one more animal before we ended this first episode off with, at least. Little female pheasant just running her way through. I don't think he should have been running this way from the gunshot. But whatever. We'll just go grab this little thing, and then I'll do a quick check of where I should try looking for the wood grouse for the second episode this weekend. I do think it's nice to be back to the Hunter Classic. It definitely feels quite a bit easier tackling it than the way the Hunter was. I think that's because there are a lot of other systems in place, like... wow, really? That was just a body for that. Okay, that's a bit odd. Yeah, it feels like it's a lot easier tackling the Hunter Classic than Way of the Hunter, just because you do have things like the certain like equipment and clothing you have on will give you benefits. I'm trying to think of what else. I think because you don't have like as dynamic of movement speeds, like you don't have a default speed and a super slow speed, you're not as penalized for moving as much. There's a lot that could be said back and forth, but it is nice to just be back to the Hunter Classic for a nice little bit of a breath of fresh air. So thank you all very much for joining me on this episode of the Hunter Classic. If you did like the video, be sure to give a like. If you have any comments, tips, or tricks, which is in the comments right down below. And next episode, we're going to try to focus and go for the wood grouse proper and show them off, hopefully, for an episode. Then we have another weekend, we'll probably go to, say, Hemeldal or something and see them a little bit more on another map. But thank you all very much for watching, and until I do see you in the next video, hunters and survivors, please remember, as always, to take care, stay alive, and happy hunting.